Okay. Well, this is gonna be weird. Okay, so some of you are probably familiar, well, most of you are familiar with Lila's birth story. We did a whole video on it, and it was mostly just about that day and what happened. But we wanted to kind of talk about what even made us think about, what made us think to do a home birth, because I know a lot of people ask these questions, and it's kind of hard to answer just typing. So, hubby told me that, he, even before he knew who he was gonna marry or anything, he always kind of liked the idea of having a home birth. He never shared it with me.
I don't know why.
Yeah, I mean, to this day, we still don't know why. But he didn't share it with me until I watched Babies, Inc. on my own. I don't even know why. No, I watched it on my own because I remember I was in the bedroom and you were in the kitchen. And I was like, oh my god, I just watched this movie. And you're like, I think I've seen it before or something. And, I was like, I totally want to do a home birth. And he's like, he gets excited. He's like, oh, thank God we're on the same page. He's like, I always wanted it, but I knew it's not my place to say anything.
I think I planned it.
You planned it. He somehow planned it. He made it happen. we connect on a, what is it?
I don't know.
It's okay. anyways, so we decided that that's how we were going to do it, and this was before I was even pregnant or we even decided to try being
pregnant.
It was
2 years before, no?
Was it 2 years
before? Yeah, I think it was 2 years before.
Before I got pregnant. And when I did get pregnant and we told everybody, everyone's like, yeah, you say this now, we'll just wait
everyone
and see.
Was like, yeah, good idea, but yeah, right, you're not going
to
do it.
Yeah, no one believed that we were going to do it until it came like close to the date, and then everyone's like, they're crazy, why are they going
to
do it?
I know, go to the hospital.
And mostly the reason for, if you watch Baby Inc, it'll kind of teach you why we decided to do it. But hospitals scare the junk out of me. I don't like how they smell. I don't like how I feel going in there. The only times I've been in there was when he had to go through surgery twice. My sister had cancer, and those are the only times, and I never liked hospitals because of that. So I was like, I really don't want to go into hospital. I feel better not being in a hospital. And I know other people will feel the opposite way, and that's perfectly fine. But for me, I didn't like them.
And just the doctor experience, the first two.
So my prenatal visit, the first one, I told him, I went in there on my own. I forgot why. Why did I go in there on my own?
I don't know.
You're waiting in the car. You don't want to come with me.
I don't know why.
Anyways, he didn't come with me, but I told him I hated the experience. I'm like, it totally sucked. And he was kind of like, okay, whatever, you know. The next one I told him, please come with me.
I'm sure it wasn't that bad.
And this time he's like, okay, I'm going to come with you. And he's just sitting in the corner of the room in disbelief, hearing what the doctor is telling me. Oh, the first time it was because the lady made me feel like I was a teenager who got pregnant and didn't have a baby daddy and all this crazy stuff. And I was just like, how can you assume this? I was like, I'm old enough. I've been married for 8 years before deciding to have a child. So that was why. But the second lady, she pretty much told me, she goes, you're a B negative, like my blood type. She didn't tell you what you were then, right?
No.
And then she's like, oh, people have died from this and babies die from this. And I was just like,
the whole time she's
freaking out. She had her back to us. Drinking her big old Coke, telling us that, you know,
Diet Coke,
telling us how we can, I could die from this and my baby could die and I wouldn't even know, and pretty much just leaves the room.
And I'm just like, what are you talking about? Like, who's gonna die right now?
Like we were so confused. Like, is this a big concern? Like, oh my god. And she just leaves the room, leaves us in there, and I'm looking at him like, what is happening?
We
you
just
know?
Looked at each other like,
she what? Didn't explain what B negative was, what it really meant, and so I went home, did a lot of research, stressed out, freaked out, cried a little because I didn't know what to expect, just to find out that the first baby's okay. It's a rare, very rare blood type, but the next pregnancy, my blood may want to go. Chances are, if our blood's mixed and Lila got his blood, then the next time I decide to have a baby, it will reject the baby and I can't get pregnant again in the future.
So there was no problem with the first one.
Yeah, there would be no problem with the first one, but she inherited my blood, not his, so either way, we're good. And then it was a simple shot that I had to take I don't know if it was
for your next pregnancy, which is she's gonna be fine, the baby.
Yeah, well, it was a shot I had to take before the pregnant, before I gave birth, and then a shot after if she did in fact get his blood, but because she didn't, I didn't need that shot. So I mean, it was a simple explanation like that, and I'd be like, okay, cool, whatever. But she totally didn't explain that, and we asked her to elaborate, and she's just like, didn't I just tell you what it is? And I was like, oh, okay, so I'm gonna die, thank you. That was the last visit. That was the last prenatal visit in a hospital.
After that, we went for a...
We went for a midwife. We were searching, and it was so difficult to find one. Let me tell you, look in advance, people, because everyone was booked. We had to settle for one. I was already 6 months pregnant by the time we found one and decided, oh my God, you're available. Okay, we're gonna stick with you, even though we don't even know if you're great or anything, which proved to be that she wasn't so great. During the whole labor, she proved to be kind of not very good. Without her nurse, I would have freaked out. My husband would have probably freaked out. Her nurse was amazing. She was the thing that kept me on my feet and actually coached me through it.
Even though it wasn't the best experience, we still would do another one.
Yeah, we decided no matter what, we would still have another home birth. We would just do a better job of picking our midwife, because ours wasn't the best. But the way it happened, I remember waking up and I was like, babe, she's coming. And he's like, right now? Like, what do you mean? I'm like, I don't know. She's gonna arrive today, though. And he's like, really? You sure? And I was like, yeah, I feel something. And it wasn't necessarily, I wasn't getting contractions yet. I just had a feeling. And then we went to the pool. We went to the pool, and I was like sitting there. I'm like, I think I'm having contractions. We didn't leave the pool or anything. We just continued to stay there.
You got there probably 11?
At the pool?
Yeah.
It was probably 11, yeah.
Yeah.
I was eating a whole lot of pineapple. Somebody told me something about eating pineapple.
We left to like 6 o'clock, really late.
Like 6, and then I think, we came home, I showered, and then around 8, I was like, things just got serious, I think. I'm like, I'm pretty sure that I'm literally going into labor now. And so I called the midwife, they arrived at 10?
No, the nurse got here around 9.
But the midwife didn't get here till like close to midnight.
Yeah,
yeah, close o'clock. To midnight.
She was doing another home birth.
Yeah, she was in the middle of another home birth. They checked me, and when they checked me, I was 7 centimeters dilated, meaning it's gonna happen soon. 10 is the max. And I was like, oh great, I'm gonna have this baby in a couple hours. Everything's gonna go smoothly. Turns out she was stubborn. I don't know what happened. She did not want to come out.
We know why now.
She arrived, what time, 11:40 the next day?
Next day, yeah.
11:40 a.m. the next day. So she put me through a lot. I think the pain was becoming more aggravating. Like, I could handle the contractions, but through time, like, it was just getting aggravating. I was getting tired.
The whole thing was 36 hours.
36 hours we were up. You were up for 40 hours,
yeah.
Right?
I think it was 3 days I was up.
It was insane. I think the perks of after having her was just being able to get in my bed and cuddle with her and hold her and be in shock that, oh my God, I just gave birth to this amazing baby. He had to change her first diaper, and it was hilarious because he was going through all the wipes, and I was like, babe, at this rate, we're gonna be broke just because we need to buy so many wipes. But it was her first poop, and I guess it's like tar or something, and we didn't know about that. He's like, it's not coming off. And he just kept using more wipes.
I think I used half of it.
Yeah. He's like, it's just not coming off. And then I don't know who told us to put coconut oil on her butt so that it just slides right off.
Yeah.
But that was a funny experience. I was like, this rate, we're not doing diaper changes very right.
But I was cleaning and cleaning. I was like, what is going on?
He's like, is poop supposed to be like this? But he got to change her first diaper. He also gave her a fever.
Yep.
That was insane. Was it the next day?
Yeah.
It was the next day. The nurse came back to check on the baby, and her temperature was 100 and...
Well, she was checking on you, and I was holding her, and her temperature was 100.
Yeah, well, first she had to check on me, and then she was going to check the baby.
104.
103 or 104, like scary temperature.
But she was sleeping.
And I started to freak out. I was like, oh my God. And she's like, it's weird. She doesn't look uncomfortable, you know? She's like, usually if they have a fever like this, they look uncomfortable. So she wasn't really sure what was going on. Turns out my husband is way too hot and he can't hold her.
Well, I realized
before checking her temperature.
I'm like, no, I think I did it. It's like, no, this is a fever. I'm like, no, it's me. Trust me.
So they gave her to me, and then not too long after, she was perfect 97 degrees. And I was like, babe, you gave our baby a fever. How can you do that?
I think the nurse was ready to take her to hospital.
I know. And I was freaking out. I was ready to start crying. Like, what do you mean? What's wrong?
And I'm like, no, she's fine.
It was pretty horrible. And then I got emotional from that, and they were like pricking her feet to get like blood samples, and then I started bawling like a baby uncontrollably, like, stop poking my baby. Like, everybody wants to hurt my baby. It was a very emotional time for me. I think I cried for like 2 weeks after having her because I loved her so much, and I was telling him like, I miss her. He's like, she's in your arms. What do you mean you miss her? I'm like, I don't know. I love her so much. I don't understand. It was pretty crazy. But
and sorry about the angles. We
had no control over that.
I had my cousins doing it.
Yeah. And we're just grateful we have clips from this. But had we had control over it, yeah, it would have been way better. But we're happy with what we have. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoy the small clip. That's kind of a little background story as to how it all happened. No regrets here if we have another one, which yeah, we may. We're going to do it all over again. Just take more time with the midwife. Plan things out better.
Bad thing was that when you were pushing, she was telling you, push it like you're pooping.
Yeah, she was giving me bad
push
direction.
Push like you're pooping. Like, what did...
Because I was pushing like I was pooping and nothing was happening. I'm like, I can't push any harder.
She was about to pass out because she had no energy for 36
hours. I mean,
because
that was hours of labor, and I was pushing. I was pushing to the point where I wanted to throw up. I mean, I had broken blood vessels all over my face, my neck. I looked crazy.
I thought you were going to pass out.
For sure, I thought I was going to
pass out. And then I'm like,
out.
I was ready to punch the midwife because it's like, listen to me, don't listen to her.
He totally yelled at her during a push. He's like, well, did you tell her to shut up or something? He's like, just shut up.
And then I was like on her ear telling her, try and push like it's your last set, like it's your last,
like you're squatting and it's your last squat,
just push it like that. You push from your core. And then she finally like gave in and listened to me.
I was like, okay, fine, I'll listen to him because whatever she's saying ain't working. And boom, she arrives. It pretty much happened like that. It was kind of crazy.
I was so mad.
And the midwife was like, those were good pointers. Like, how long have you been doing this for? Like, yeah. Why didn't she give those kind of pointers?
Later on, she told me, like, you did a good job. It was a good point for you. Like,
it
really?
Was funny because she's like, but did you yell at me? He's like, I was yelling at both of you. I was like, babe, you're not yelling at me. He's like, yeah, I know, but I didn't know what to say. I did yell at her. It was pretty funny.
And pretty bad at that moment.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. Just because of those reasons. But other than that, it was beautiful. And I really liked it and enjoyed it. And this is our baby, by the way. I didn't know if she's in the camera. Our gorgeous, gorgeous girl. Healthy and happy. So anyways, we kind of cut the clip a little bit. There's a longer version if you guys want to see that. But then it's kind of a 10-minute version, and we tried to kind of keep it like PG, as PG as possible. So enjoy her home birth.
Wake me up. We're still half asleep. 8 o'clock on the dot, people. You're doing so good, Lori.
There you go.
She's got a whole 45 more seconds.
Crazy little girl.
Wow! Huh? Look at that girl!
Sorry.
Oh, she's
oh, baby.
Look at that hat! Oh. You want to take that white thing off so you can
yeah, because this is going to get wrecked.
This doesn't matter.
Oh, this one? This warm one right here? It's not warm one. The towel that's right next to the heating gas. That was.
Here she is.
You did.
Oh my god.
Uh-oh, your makeup got messed
up. Oh my god.
Oh, who cares?
Oh, okay. Well, this one's warm, but it's not very big. But it's warm.
Oh, baby.
Take that.
Oh,
she's so oh. The cord is very short.
Oh, really?
Holy crap.
Oh, god.
Crap indeed. Here's a second one. Just keep her there for a moment. Boy.
Wow.
I couldn't figure out
that
I wanted
to hurt. Oh my god, that was so awesome.
Everybody okay?
Yeah.
Okay, one have clean undies still? Does everyone have clean undies? No. Where's the head? In the bowl.
Good job, Lori. You did it. Can I just get a close-up on her? Welcome to the world, Lila.
Is that still running?
Hi, Lila.
Everybody was yelling and screaming.
She looks...